Hello, Errichto here. Today I will solve problem painting the fence from a recent educational round 61 in Codeforces. There is a fence consisting of n sections and there are q painters. For each painter we know what interval of sections he will paint. We can only hire q-2 painters, in other words we must remove two of them, and we want to maximize the number of painted sections. Sections that are covered by at least one painter. So sections that are inside at least one interval. Both n and q are up to 5000. On the right we can see one of the sample tests from the statement. In this case it's optimal, for example, to remove these two intervals. After that the three sections here are painted and the answer will be three. There are also other possibilities. For example, we can remove these two short intervals and still those three sections will be painted. And it's impossible to paint all four sections if you want to remove two intervals. I will talk about two solutions today. One of them is able to solve even harder version of a problem where we hire q-5 painters. We remove five of them and we want to maximize the number of painted sections. I suggest that you pause the video now and try to solve this problem and maybe even harder version yourself. I want to iterate over pairs of painters or pairs of intervals that I will remove. On the right, you can see the draft of my code where I'm iterating over interval 1 and interval 2 that I will remove. But before that, I can have some computation or preprocessing, even in n square. I called it for now A. Then after I iterate over the first interval, I can again do some preprocessing, this time maybe in O of n. And then inside the two for loops, I will have that part last part, C, that must be in constant time, so that the total complexity would be n square. First, my preprocessing A will be to compute count of I for every position, the number of times this section is covered by some intervals. For the sample test here, I have 1, 2, 2, 1, and then after I iterate over the first interval, let's decrease the count. If this is the interval that I'm removing, then the counts will decrease to 1, 2, 1, 0. I can do that in linear time, just going through that array. And then what happens after I will remove a second interval? I know that right now the number of covered sections is 3. After I remove a new interval, some new sections will be not painted, so the score will decrease. The score will decrease by the number of sections in this new interval, second interval, that are equal to 1, because those will decrease to 0. If this interval is a second to be removed, the sequence of counts would change to 1, 1, 0, 0. And the score would decrease from 3 to 2 because of this 0. What I want to do in this case is mark once in this sequence and say that for every next interval I want to know how many ones it covers, because those will be cells, those will be positions that will change to 0 and thus the score will decrease. And so I want to make that last part C fast, and for that I will use prefix sums. Let's put one in every position where there is one in my sequence of counts, and if I apply prefix sums here I can quickly say what is the sum of elements in some interval. We then know that part B should be decrease counts and then do prefix sums. Prefix sums. And part C should be just O of 1, where we ask our prefix sums for the number of ones in some interval. The total complexity will be n square because of part A, or maybe n times q, depending on our implementation. I think it will be n times q. And later we iterate over the pairs of intervals, what gives us q square anyway, and the total complexity will be nq plus q square. What is fine for these constraints? In a moment we will see the implementation to make things more clear, and then we'll move to the harder solution. The solution will be available in my GitHub repository, for which the link is in the description of the video. Here we read the input n and q. We have a vector of pairs that represent intervals. For every interval we read it, I prefer indices from 0 to n minus 1 instead of 1 through n, so I decrease the start and end by 1. Then I increase the count for every section or position in between of p first and p second. And this is my part A from the drawing on the right, where we compute count of I. Answer is 0. At the end, we will print answer. What happens in between? I iterate over uppercase A, that is the index of the first interval. I will eventually later iterate over B, the other interval, from A plus 1 to Q. What happens before that? I create for positions between first and second of this interval, I decrease count of I. At the end, I will roll back this change, so I increase it back. Then I count positive numbers, so the score right now, what happens on the right here with f3. Then we count prefix sums on the number of ones that I computed here. If count of I is 1, then increase the number of ones here, then compute prefix sum of ones. Function getSum takes L and R and returns the prefix sum from L to R. So ones of R minus ones of L minus 1. Unless L is 0, then we don't want to go out of the array to check index minus 1. So the if is for that. Finally, we iterate over the index of the second interval B. We know how many ones will change to 0. This is the number of ones in this interval. So we use function getSum from intervals of B first to second. And answer we maximize with count positive numbers, so from the right it was this 3, minus the number of ones that are changed to 0. At the end we print answer. An alternative solution is quite standard dynamic programming on intervals. Let's sort the intervals by the beginning, and then define dp of x used as the maximum number of painted sections so far, if x is the last painted section and used is the number of intervals we took so far. At the end we want to take q minus 2 intervals, or in the harder version q minus 5. How does it work? Well, after we process those intervals, maybe this will be the interval that is taken and reaches as far as possible to the right. So apparently we didn't take this one, and this will be our x. We also know how many intervals we took. And if we have a new interval here, we know what is the number of new sections that we paint. This will be from x to this position, and used is increased by the length of this new segment of painted sections. The complexity of that will be O of x can be up to n, used can be up to q or q minus 2, and times we go through all the whole two-dimensional array for each new interval, and there are q of them. So the complexity is nq square, which is obviously too much. but instead of used, we can define this dimension as skipped. So we increase it by one only if we don't use an interval, and then this Q is changed to the number of painters that we must remove. So in the easy version this would be 2, in our even harder version this is 5. And O of n times Q times quite small constant factor is enough to get accepted in this problem. This is of course a more general solution that will always also work for example 50 painters, if we want to remove 50 painters, but then n and q should be slightly slower, like 1000, because otherwise the constant factor is too big here. Let's now see the implementation of this solution. I sort intervals, and by default in C++ pairs are sorted first by the first number and then by a second number. I define dp of n 3. I assume that we must remove 2 painters, so we are solving a problem from Codeforces, not the harder version, but otherwise this should be changed to the number of painters we must remove plus 1. And I fill that with minus infinity, just I must somehow initialize dp, and dp of 0, 0 is 0. I iterate over the intervals, and inside I iterate over x to which position we reach and the number of skipped intervals so far. Just remember to iterate over those decreasingly from n to 0 here and from 2 to 0 here. Otherwise, you can move from a state to another state using this interval or skipping this interval. But after that, you will move to that other state and you will again consider that interval. Possibly you will say this way that you're using the same interval to skip this, to increase the number of skipped intervals by 1, and then again by 1, and so on. This would be incorrect. So just like in knapsack, we iterate over dimensions decreasingly. Extra is that length of a blue segment on the right, this one, which is p second minus maximum of x and p first. This maximum is because if the new interval is here, then we don't take this second minus x, only second minus first. We say that only these are sections that are painted right now. If skipped is not 2, then we consider going to skipped plus 1 and we don't increase the number of painted sections. And we also consider taking this interval. We move to dp of max of x and p second plus 1. P second plus 1 will be the, instead of defining x as the last painted section as I drawn on the right, here I define it will be a cell just after that. This is why I have this plus 1. And extra is that number of new painted cells, and this will be the total number of painted cells. At the end, I take the maximum over dp of i2, 2 represents the number of skipped intervals, and I want to have 2 skipped intervals, and I print the answer. Both this implementation and the previous one you can find in the GitHub repository. I hope you like the problem. If yes, consider subscribing to the channel and sharing the video with your friends. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye!